So NASG is a low-cost first aid device to control persistent PPH. This is made up of, NASG garment is made up of neoprene and it has six segments. They are numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 1, 2 and 3 are for the lower set. They are for the lower limb and 4, 5 and 6 are for the pelvis and abdomen. Now, whenever you are placing this NASG, ensure that the upper border of this garment, of the upper segment, is at the lowermost rib. Now, how to apply this NASG garment? Once it is placed properly, you start closing the segments from below upwards. So, segment 1 is closed tightly across the ankle. Segment 2 tightly across the, it is closed tightly across the calf muscles, and segment 3 is closed across the thighs. Ensure that the knees are free so that you can flex these knees. Then segment 4 is closed tightly across the pelvis. Segment 5 is closed over the umbilicus. Ensure that it is, the pillow is over the umbilicus, and finish closing it by closing segment 6. Now, once you have closed these, you introduce two fingers and pull them out so that it makes a snap test. This shows that it is applied properly. It is neither too tight and neither it is very loose. The patient should be able to breathe comfortably through this.
You can see that the knees are free.
The knees are free so that it can be flexed if required. Now, how does this work? This garment was designed based on the print technology from NASA, because they had designed anti-gravity garments for their astronauts to prevent them from blacking out during extreme acceleration. What it does is that it directs the blood from the lower extremities and the abdomen and pelvis towards the head and heart so that the shock is reversible.
And you can shift the patient in OT.
The with this advantages
are, you can shift the patient to the OT along with the NASG garment, and you can remove the only abdominal segment whenever you want to do the laparotomy. You can flex the knees because they are open, so you can do exploration also along with this in situ. And you can give the massage also because the abdominal segment is stretchable. So there is no need to remove the abdominal segment. You have to remove one segment one by one. Observe the vital signs for 15 minutes, and it takes around 60 minutes to remove all the NASG. If there is a fall in BP or there is a tachycardia, then you may have to reapply the segment one by one. And you start removing from segment 1 up to segment 6.
If in between the segments, like if you remove first segment, you wait for 15 minutes and check for the vitals. The other important thing we have is aortic compression. And this is also very effective in life-threatening situations. You apply compression over the aorta with a closed fist at the level of the umbilicus and just a little to the left side of it. The compression should be such that when you palpate the femoral pulsations, they will disappear. When the femoral pulsations disappear, it indicates that the compression is sufficient. It has to be, keep your hands straight, and it can be reinforced with the other hand.
First feel the pulsations.
But first feel, patient may feel uncomfortable while you are doing this aortic compression. Patient may feel uncomfortable, but you will have to palpate the femoral and see that whether it is effective.
This aortic compression can be done even when the abdomen is open. So in that case, you compress slightly above the sacral promontory, or the other area is just below where the renal arteries are arising from the aorta. So these are two important things which they work very well. This NASG garment works very well. And it is reusable. It can be washed and can be used again for about 40 times or even more than that.